And retired longtime Republican Senator John Warner of Virginia died of heart failure last night at his home in Alexandria. John Yang takes a look at his life.
Hearing no objection, so ordered.
John Warner represented Virginia in the Senate for 30 years, respected on both sides of the aisle for his independence and efforts at consensus building. A former Navy secretary and veteran of both World War II and the Korean War, he was an important voice on military affairs.
America has always led in the cause of freedom.
As Armed Services Committee Chairman, Warner backed President George W. Bush on the Iraq War, but split with the Commander-in-Chief over his later troop buildup.
Wake up. We're paying a heavy price.
His independent streak was also on display when he opposed President Reagan's bid to put Robert Bork on the Supreme Court, defied the NRA on gun issues, and refused to back fellow Virginia Republican Oliver North's 1994 Senate campaign. Warner was first elected in 1978, often campaigning with his then-wife, actress Elizabeth Taylor. She would introduce herself as a housewife from a small town in Virginia. After retiring from the Senate in 2009, he endorsed Democrats, including Hillary Clinton for president in 2016, and Virginia's current senators, Tim Kaine and Mark Warner, no relation, who narrowly lost a 1996 bid to unseat John Warner. In the Senate today, Republican leader Mitch McConnell remembered his former colleague.
My predecessor as chairman of the Rules Committee was a principled patriot across the board. He was also a truly old-school Virginia gentleman.
In 2009, the Navy named a submarine for Warner.
Ship's company, attend, hut.
An uncommon honor for a living person. Its home port, Norfolk, Virginia. Warner died with his wife and family at his side. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm John Yang.
John Warner was 94 years old.